also make a video on a particular topic that is of importance from your main's point of view or from your from the point of view of your syllabus. So we have decided to make today's video on the sugar industry. So there are a lot of problems in the sugar industry of India. So in this video we will be discussing what are these problems, what is that thing that ails Indian sugar industry, and what could be the way forward. So it is a must a must watch video, because it will help you in clearing your concepts about the sugar sector and the industry based on it. So friends, before starting, let me explain to you people that what is the importance of the sugar industry. So the importance I have tried to explain by including some facts and figures. So let me explain to tell to you friends that currently the annual turnover of this sugar industry is ₹55,000 crore, and the largest taxpayer to central exchequer, one of the largest taxpayer to the central exchequer, that is, it pays ₹2,600 crore annually. So you can see the importance of this sugar industry in the revenue of the center. And also there is an important role played by sugar industry when it comes to the contribution to the state exchequer, state revenue. And also friends, regarding the employability in the sector, there is a data that currently 5 crore farmers and their dependents, including the agricultural laborers, are dependent upon sugarcane cultivation, harvesting and other ancillary activities. So 5 crore is not a small number, if we include the dependents and agricultural laborers, then this number may reach to 10 to 15 crore. So a lot of people are dependent upon this sugarcane industry. And regarding sugar mills, 5 lakh skilled and unskilled workers are employed in the sugar mills that process the sugarcane to produce sugar. So if we come to an estimate, then approximately 7.5% of India's rural population depends on this industry, either directly or indirectly. So you can see how much important the sugar sector is. So regarding production, let's see what are the figures that are reached at in this season. So it is predicted that in this season, which will end on September 2019, the production of sugar will be 35.5 million tons. So it is the expected production, and it is this expectation is made by Indian Sugar Mills Association. So last season this production was 32 million tons. So you can see there is an increase in production of sugar. So India is, let me tell you friends, that India is the largest consumer of sugar. So in fact it is also it is the largest consumer, and it consumes 26 million tons of sugar every year. And if we go by these figures, then this year the surplus would be approximately 10 million tons. So India will kind of also in terms of quantity of production this time, this year, India will surpass Brazil, which was until now the largest producer of sugar. But now India will cross it, and India will also become the largest producer apart from the largest consumer. So friends, what should concern us and what should be noticed here is the thing that it is not the case that Brazil is producing less sugar cane, or the efficiency of their sugar mills is reducing or less. We can't say this, because they are deliberately reducing the production of sugar. Rather, they are using sugarcane to produce ethanol, which is more kind of, we can say, more profitable. Keeping in mind that currently the global market is not showing good signs for the sugar industry, and sugar is seeing depressed prices. So there is not much profitability in the context of sugar production of sugar. So high profits are available for ethanol. So that's why these Brazil farmers are going for ethanol production rather than for sugar production. So sugar cane is produced there, but its use has been altered to produce more ethanol, which is more profitable. So let's see what ails our sugar industry. So I have included certain points, so you can see that 48% of the sugar mills that in fact 48% of the sugar that is produced, it is produced by cooperative initiatives, cooperative sector. So farmers have cooperatives, and such cooperatives have the sugar mills which produce 48% of the product total production. So, but the despite being the largest one of the largest producers of sugar, the problem with this sector is that some states still control cooperative sector because they appoint government administrators to manage such type of cooperative mills. So in this in multiple way hinders the productivity of the sugar mill, and the functioning is also is not democratic, because if the government appointed functionary is there, the functioning cannot be said democratic, because ultimately the cooperative is being run by the people or by the farmers, but the government appointed administrators they cause hindrance in these sugar mills, and these sugar mills fail to realize their actual potential. Other thing is that production cost of sugar varies from factory to factory, and it is average. If we take average, then it is rupees 35 to 4000 per quintal. So whereas if we see the selling prices of sugar, then it is rupees 3000 to rupees 3400. So you can clearly see that the production cost is more and the selling price is less. Obviously it causes loss to the sugar and sugar mills. So and this price that I'm telling you of 3,3400, that too is excluding excise duty. So sugar mills hardly make any profit, and they fail to make timely payment due to this to the farmers, because farmers they sell their sugar cane to sugar mills, but when the financial position of sugar mills is not well, when they face losses, they fail to pay payments to the farmers on time. So that kind of problem creates stress in the agriculture sector also, because when farmers do not get the timely payment, they have to take loan for the next cultivation season. So the amount for remuneration is also less, and it has to be then arranged by government intervention time and again. So government intervenes and then it pays to sugar mills so that they can pay to the farmers. So obviously when such a situation is such situation emerges, you can see that certainly the farmers will not be getting remunerative prices. Obviously they will be getting only that much money so that they can compensate for their production cost. So the other thing is that the technology in sugar mills is old and decaying. So the technology that is used to convert sugarcane into sugar mills, it is old and decaying, due to which it compromises the productivity of the mill as well as efficiency. So other thing is that sugar mills focus upon just production of sugar. So they just produce sugar. They don't go for diversification. As I have told you that in Brazil, the farmers have went for diversification, and in fact they are producing ethanol and that is alcohol, and they are earning huge profits. But in our sugar mills, problem is that the production is of sugar only, and that is not much profitable, and they are becoming, these sugar mills are becoming financially unviable. So diversification of production is not there. That is a mix of sugar, alcohol and exportable power. So power, that is electricity, can also be produced by the biomass of the sugar cane. So that is not done in case of Indian sugar mills. So way forward, what should be the way forward? So first of all, let me tell you friends that sugar cane is a very important crop, and it is fast growing primary feedstock, and it has the high capacity to absorb carbon dioxide. So as you know, that carbon dioxide is a main greenhouse gas, and it contributes in increasing the global warming. So certainly planting sugarcane will reduce the carbon, because these sugarcane farms will act like carbon sinks. So its production must be encouraged. The government must encourage its production. But the other thing that the government can do is it can restrict the production of excess sugar. And extra sugarcane must be utilized for diversified products, as I have told you earlier, that it could be used for production of alcohol, ethanol, electricity. So this will, what this will ensure? It will ensure profitability to sugar mills. And they can self-sustain themselves without any government support and intervention. And they can also pay farmers on time. So other thing that should be done is that obsolete machinery must be replaced so that productivity and efficiency of the mill could be enhanced. Here an important thing also is that we can also increase the selling price of sugar, but some will not agree with this point. I'm just including it for you people to decide that whether to accept it or not. So some people are suggesting that we can increase the price of selling price of sugar to minimum rupees 4000 to rupees 4500 per quintal. So the argument that is given by such people is that currently 75% of the sugar is consumed by bulk consumers. That is companies that sugar in the production of their goods, for example bakery industry, ice cream industry, and milk industry, dairy products industries. So only 25% is meant for domestic use, and the price rise would not make any impact on the monthly expenses. Other argument that they make is that the expenditure on sugar, the domestic expenditure on sugar is not that much, as in the case with the pulses and with the products like milk, which is 45 to 50 rupees per liter, and also petrol, which is also quite costly. So the expenses of the households on other products is more as compared to the expenditure on sugar. So they are arguing that the prices can be increased. So however, the one thing that must be done is that we must just not focus on production of sugar. We must go for sugar complexes. What is sugar complexes? That is a mill that is capable of producing sugar also, and it is capable of producing electricity as well as alcohol also, so that these mills can become viable, economically viable, and can compensate farmers, and can become self-reliant. So this is the way forward. Regarding lastly, this point I want to include it. There also exists a case for more ethanol production and for diversification, because there is a synergy of industry with other government policies. Because currently, let me tell you friends, that recently Government of India has unveiled ethanol blending program, in which it has made the target that 10% there must be 10% blending of ethanol with petrol. And but this blending will ensure, it will first of all cut the imports of crude oil from abroad, and also it will ensure that the fuel is more efficient and environmental friendly. So but the oil marketing companies have so far managed only to achieve 1.37% blending. So there is much scope that is there for blending, and obviously ethanol much larger quantity of ethanol is needed to meet the 10% target. So with this 10% blending, government can save rupees 18,000 crore per year that would have been otherwise spent on the import of crude oil. So production by ethanol by sugar mills can help meet this target. And currently also India is importing 80 to 85% of crude oil, and this dependence upon crude oil is likely to increase in 8 to 10 years to 90 to 95%. Whereas if we see the case of Brazil has managed to reduce its dependence on crude oil from 67% to 45 to 50% in over the period of time of 35 to 40 years. So ethanol blending, what will this ensure? It will reduce the dependence on these organization of petroleum exporting countries, and also it will make fuel more environmental friendly, and will help in reducing the emission of greenhouse gases. So the union government must decide that the quantity that is to be produced of sugar, and also it must decide well before the season that how much sugar is to be produced and how much alcohol is to be produced, so that it could be ensured that there is no surplus production of sugar and then consequent glut in the market and then consequent losses to the sugar mills and to the farmers. And this can only be done if there is a kind of pre-season intervention, so that the farmers can get to know about how much sugar is to be produced and how much alcohol, and this sugar mills can decide that how much sugar is to be produced and how much alcohol and how much electricity is to be produced. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like this video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And also, friends, if you have any suggestion, if you want us to make a video on other topics, then you can certainly tell us in the comment box. We will certainly look into your demand. And lastly, we also want to tell you that if you want to download the PDF of this lecture, then you can visit these links. That is, this is our website link, that is www.achieveias.co.in, and this is our Telegram channel. Here also you can download the PDF, and this is our YouTube channel. Here also you can visit and subscribe to our channel. And lastly, friends, this is all about our video. If you like the video, then do ensure that you subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications about the updates that we do on our channel. So thank you, friends. Have a very nice day.